30 seconds and counting. Astronauts report it feels good. T-minus 25 seconds. 20 seconds and counting. T-minus 15 seconds. Guidance is internal. 12, 11, 10, 9. Ignition sequence starts. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff. 32 minutes.
Is there anybody out there that wants to roll? And is there anybody out there that wants to boogie? Tonight, live from the Apollo, Glasgow.
Well, if you're looking for trouble, I'm the man to see. If you're looking for satisfaction, it's satisfaction guaranteed.
Welcome to Glasgow Apollo Live with Scott and Andy.
That was the quite as professional as I'd hoped. Good evening.
Well, that's up to our standard then.
Well, good evening and welcome to Glasgow Apollo Live. With me, Scott, shooking on a victory v MacArthur.
And me, Andy Muir, having a cup of tea.
Oh, God, we're living the rock and roll lifestyle tonight, mate. How are you doing?
Woo! Yes. Very well, thank you. And how good. Are you yourself, sir?
I'm all right. I'm very surprised that we managed to sustain this for 50 shows.
So are the three people watching. But, that's me and you.
and my son.
Someone
Bertie.
Else.
Yeah. But
Bertie. Hello, Bertie.
Hi, Bertie. What's he doing? Oh no, he's downstairs being sick, I think. He's always been sick at the moment. It's funny. Anyway. So good evening. Welcome to the show. It's our 50th show. So we're just gonna have we're gonna play Supper's Ready and Grendel, and that'll be the end of it. What do you reckon?
Short show.
If you are first-time viewers, please put your name and where you're tuning in from into the chat. That would be great. And if you're tuning in from the Facebook group, as I say every week, if you can click on that little web address there, just follow instructions, just a couple of clicks these days, and it'll mean that your name will pop up in the chat. Unlike if you look, there's someone here, probably somebody we know. This one here, look, see? It says, "Hi guys, Facebook user." Now, that person's probably clicked on the link before, but it's gone away for some reason. So you need to click on it again. It's at the top of the Facebook group. You'll find it there. So if you don't mind doing that, that would be great. And every week...
In the chat.
Have you put it in the chat? Have you?
Yes.
Good.
You should just put it there as a matter of course and say, click that link. Come on.
Well, you could do it. You could do it. I don't need to do it. Greetings from Tatty Toon on the Côte d'Ayrshire. Excellent. I love it. Excellent. And here's a first timer. Hello, John. How are you doing? Nice to meet you. John from Straven, first time in. Thanks for coming in, John. That's brilliant. And I've got someone else in here. Oh, my goodness. Right. Looking forward to the show. I'm Zara from LinkedIn, and I'm from the south of Gatwick. Hello. Thanks very much for tuning in. I don't usually put this on LinkedIn, Zara. But we thought, because it was our 50th show, we'd put it on because it's a big step for us tonight. So thanks very much for tuning in. It's nice to know somebody's there. What are you saying? What's wrong with you?
Behave. Big step. Sure, big step.
It is. I tell you what, right? In my professional capacity, in my other job, nobody gets to 50 shows. They all give up after two or three. I mean, understandably. But wow. You know, it's cool, you know. We'll get there.
Still people. What the public wants.
Exactly, exactly. So who you been listening to? Thank you, Zara. See, there's a nice person there. You see, unlike you giving me abuse. Zara's saying thank, well done, congratulations. See,
banter, mate.
Banter. Okay. Anyway, what have you been listening to?
What have I been listening to? Okay. Oof, lots of stuff. Do you want me to tell you what I've been listening
don't
to?
Don't go through the list of the 50 gigs we're going to talk about.
See, what, tell us the ones you, that are interesting. The other day, when you put on the Facebooks, you put the Frankie Miller song and Paul Kossoff song on.
Ah, the one that I
don't know where the sun don't. I know why the sun don't shine, right? I think that's what it's called. Right. So I listened to Frankie Miller.
He was singing it 10 minutes ago, folks. He was belting it out 10 minutes ago.
And then I listened to his source, Otis Redding.
I
listened to, go down a wee pathway. And I listened to Donny Hathaway. You ever heard of him?
No, who's Donny Hathaway?
Mate, you gotta listen to him. He does Donny a brilliant Hathaway. Version of Jealous Guy.
Oh, great song.
And Frankie Miller does a version of Jealous Guy.
Of course.
And also Solomon Burke, who Frankie Miller did one of his songs as well. When your baby.
Oh yes, I know it.
That guy.
Who was it? Rick Beato was saying this week, why do people not say baby in songs anymore?
They do. He just doesn't listen to songs that have got baby in them. He's listening to Tommy Emmanuel.
You might be right. You might be right. But
he's very good.
There's Donny Hathaway there. There you go. Look,
Donny Hathaway, brilliant singer, pianist, died very young.
Oh, dear.
Very young. Great singer.
So that was
my extracurricular activity.
Yeah. I hope the standard hasn't fallen on the 50 gigs you're going to talk about.
Nah.
Excellent. So I got somebody said last week in the Facebooks that they liked Budgie, and I remember seeing Budgie. I think they supported Oswald, didn't they? They did support Ozzy, didn't they? They did. And I think they played the Apollo 3 or 4 times, and I think I saw them a couple of times. So I listened to this one, obviously, Bread Fan, which everybody's heard, at least most folk have heard. Why is the video not showing? Can you see the video?
No, I see black screen.
See? It worked when we tested it. No, it's not working. You see, it's not very good. But no, I listened to it, and I'm going to see if I can redo that, because it's actually quite good. And I liked it. So then I looked up to see if I could find any rescued recordings from the stage, from the Apollo. And I couldn't. And it kind of got me into thinking about, this is an awful long story, sorry folks, into Welsh music, Welsh bands. And I ended up full circle with one of the bands we talked about last week, a band called Man. Well, that's not necessarily a bad thing, but it's good. They're good riffs, and a couple of the songs were absolutely brilliant. Anyway, so I ended up going back to the group Man that we talked about, I think it was in 2 shows ago, that we weren't really that familiar with. And would believe it that somebody's put a recording from the Glasgow Apollo onto the YouTubes? So tonight we're going to have a bit of Man. And it's probably something most of us have never heard. I mean, I've never heard anything by them. I'm sure the professor and co have heard something, but I'm not a band I know much about. This boy's voice is quite mental, if you hear his voice. Yeah. Bit of a geek, but I think he's quite cool. So anyway, that's what I was listening to.
Because he's wearing glasses.
Yeah, well, he looks a bit like Geddy Lee, you know, he's got that sort of look. He's a Welshie, so that's what I've been listening to. I got tickets to Blue Street.
Eh? And a big nose. Hair glasses and a big nose.
Aye. Well, that's a geek. Well, I've not got a big nose though. Thanks, Tony, for that. And somebody's saying Metallica cover. Yeah, I heard the Metallica cover. I don't think the Metallica cover's as good as the Budgie version. Why did they call themselves Budgie? You know, it's a bit like that band Family. You know, we were another revelation to you and I when we started listening to them. If they called themselves something else, like the Devil's Family or something, maybe folk would have listened to them. Anyway, so
that was the thing.
Bands
call themselves weird names.
I like ZZ Top. Anyway, it works.
Free.
Well, that's true. Anyway, let's do this thing we did. I interrupted you with the stinger there. What were you about to say? You can't remember. Look, he's thinking, what was I going to say?
Bands.
Free. You're going to say something about free.
So if you're on the internet and you're looking up for free music.
Oh, it's horrible. That's impossible. Yeah.
So you have to free bands. But see, they weren't forward thinking about the internet then.
Or maybe they were. Anyway, what's the gen this week? It's massive again. Look at this, folks.
Yes.
Good lord.
Okay, you want me to start? I'll go. Obviously.
50 weeks we've been doing this, right? 50 weeks.
Surprising me that we do this bit first. Anyway.
What bit would you like to do first? We can change the order if you want. We can change the order.
No, it's fine. Just the order in my head doesn't work.
Ah, right, I see. Okay.
The Choral and Orchestral Union of Glasgow played December the 3rd, 1950. Oh, geez, what a gig that was. Rocking in the aisles there.
We did have somebody that went to it, didn't we? They commented on the Facebook. I'm sure they did.
Did they?
Aye, was there not a religious thing? Was there not a bit of a religious element to it? And there was some dialogue about some people thinking it was inappropriate and other people saying, well, I can do what I like. You know, I'm sure there was, mate.
I don't know.
I think there was. I'm not sure. I think there was. I should never say sure.
I don't know. Okay. I'm pretty sure they were great and they were doing the business there. T-Rex played on December the 3rd, 1970. Sorry, Mr. T-Rex. There you go. There's your picture. Is that might be the picture from that gig, but
I think it is.
It's a picture from the Apollo.
Yeah, it's certainly the Apollo.
Two or three times. Mm-hmm. Brilliant. There's your wee. There's okay. Here's the debate.
Oh, here we go. Archduke isn't the right height.
See where that guy's sitting on the stage? That's like a curtain stage. Is that that?
Aye, I think so.
That was where the orchestra used to go, and then they just filled that part up and built it up to where
Mark Bolan.
I was going to say Paul Stanley for some reason. Mark Bolan is.
Yeah.
That's where the stage line is.
Yeah.
That looks a bit precarious.
It does. It's quite a scary one. That
good
one.
Idea, but it looks a bit scary. Yeah. I mean, look at the crowd going wild. King Crimson, Lloyd Watson, Loudon Wainwright III played on Friday. I'm not sure about Loudon Wainwright playing that gig, but Friday, December the 1st. I listened to the Lark's Tongues in Aspic.
Oh, yes.
Quite good, quite weird. Not bad. Good.
What do you mean by weird?
Pardon?
What do you mean by weird? How was it weird?
Well, sorry, it was proggy. Sorry.
That's good.
Yeah, it was good. It was all right. Led Zeppelin played December the 3rd, 1972. This is the second of their, the first of their gigs this week. I listened to this show. Brilliant show. Mr. McAdam put me onto the YouTubes for it because I didn't think it was on there, but it's on there.
Couple of versions.
It's very good. Good, some good banter from Mr. Plant.
They were pretty raw, weren't they? And that it was great to hear them being like that. Near the end, they got a bit twiddly. You know, they went a wee bit too many solos and too many, you know, big long drum solos and stuff. But
I enjoyed it. I thought it was a great gig.
Well, as I'm saying, I love that gig. It's like the antithesis of the song remains the same, though. Because you listen to that, you could, God, it's like, geez, oh, another guitar solo, you know? So, yeah, it was very good.
No, it's really good. Yeah, you can't, if it had been recorded properly, it would have been, you know.
Yeah.
I didn't even, there was a couple of times Robert Plant gave a bit of a bum note, but Jesus Christ, mate, he was singing for nearly two and a half hours. Brilliant. Really good. There was some weird guitar going on as well, but that's all right. But I would have loved to have been there.
Oh, me too.
You lucky people who went to that gig. Okay, Duke Ellington played, there was two nights, he did two performances this night on Wednesday, November the 28th, 1973. Now this was, I heard some folks saying, oh, he cut it short, and he cut the gig short, but he was playing two nights in Glasgow in November, three days before, he'd been in Kinshasa.
Are they?
Flew to Italy, then flew to London, then did a performance in London on the day they arrived, and then did a gig the day before they did the Glasgow gig, and then did two nights in Glasgow, and then carried on with the tour after that.
Good Lord. And,
well, you're bound to be a bit tired.
Yeah. And we got some...
And I don't think they were meant to go to Africa because they were in Italy, or they were somewhere, they were in Europe, and then they flew to Africa. And I was looking on a website and it had all this stuff from the American government, cables from the government saying what they were doing and where they were going and who they were seeing. So it was like FBI stuff going on there. It was very interesting. It was very interesting indeed to read all that stuff, but it was really good. But I think I read something about he felt like he was being used. He was being used by the government to push the American sort of line.
Yes,
in Africa, like a good black guy has. This is what black people are like in America. So you must come to. I don't know, but it just seemed like they were pushing a bit of a line there. I could be wrong. If I'm not here next week.
Interesting story behind it as well, because Aidan, who sent that ticket to us, and Aidan's done a couple of these, he's come up with these unusual and rare tickets, and he was tidying up some old paperwork of his dad's, and this ticket literally fell out of an envelope, right. And there it was, you know.
I did listen to lots of his records this week. That's what I fell asleep to last night. Great. Brilliant. Yeah. What a band. What a, some soul. Anyway, great. Yeah. If you like it, go and have a listen. If you don't,
no, absolutely.
Give it a go. Open your mind. Dionne Warwick played November the 29th, 1973. Now, I can't remember the name of her album, but I listened to this album. That was fine. It was good. But the gig would have been great because she'd be a fantastic performer. Professional. Been great. But she just left her other record label and then she got some new songwriters. But they sort of changed the sound a little to be a bit more contemporary, but she probably was very good. Now this band here, the Peddlers, who were the support band, these guys were, you've never heard of them, have you?
Nope. Definitely not.
What a revelation these guys are, man.
All right.
Holy moly. English band. Two of them are from Liverpool and one of them was from Dorset, right?
Right.
They had listened to this album they had called Sweet London, SUITE.
Right.
So they're playing tracks from that album. It's amazing. It's just really? This bonkers, like, what's it like? It's sort of like, you know, like lo-fi.
Oh yeah, right.
Hip hop.
Really?
A lot of the sounds that are on the Peddlers album have been sampled.
All right.
Used in sort of not goldie, but or Portishead, but that kind of more cheaper 07 type.
Ah, thing. Right, okay.
That Hammond organ and Rhodes piano, mad. The guy's some great singer, but revelation. When I put it on, I was like, I don't understand these guys, but
yeah,
I was like, what? It was brilliant. I was so surprised. Anyway, yeah, I'll look them up. Good. You have a listen to it if you fancy.
Yeah,
I'll
look them up.
I'm not big revelation for me. Good. I'll listen to them again. Rory Gallagher and Strider played November 30th, 1973. Also listened to Rory Gallagher live album from 74. I think it was around about the same time. Brilliant. You lucky people who went to see Rory Gallagher.
Oh, yeah. You have no idea how lucky you are.
You buggers.
I still don't quite get his voice. You know, I struggle with that a wee bit. I know that's heresy for a lot of folk to tune in here, but I still find that a bit. It's like, oh, shut up and just play guitar, would you, Rory? But I'm sure it's an acquired sound that you get.
Get used to it, I think.
He's
not your traditional blues singer.
No, he's not. No.
Yeah, but he's good. He's still good. Yeah. He's good. Sings in tunes, fine. Plays guitar really well. Really, really well.
Genius. Yeah.
And I didn't listen to Strider. Sorry. Coralina. These are sort of. I think they were a sort of. Oh, they played November 28th, 1974. I listened to Coralina. Why? I don't know, but it wasn't my thing.
What was it? Was it? I had the impression it was just like a choral group or something.
They were, yes, but
yeah,
good, yes, but they were more. They were, I think, they were from Germany or Scandinavia, and sang sort of. Religious songs,
yeah.
I'd hear the occasional Hallelujah and Jesu. Right. There's Latin as well. Anyway, they were all right.
We're getting some good feedback here. Where are the Hairy Chesters? They're gonna come.
Don't worry, mate. Don't worry, Boots. They're coming. I think that was Boots.
That was.
Okay, Argent and Clancy, Hairy Chesters, one and all. Friday, November 29th, 1974. I listened to that, the album from this, just two. Good, I enjoyed it. But I'm not
describe Argent to the viewers then. I'm not sure about Argent.
Well, the song God gave Rock and Roll to you is the first track on there.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a good song.
You cannot.
It's good. It's good music. I think there was two different sort of bands in Argent. I think one was a bit proggy, one was a bit rocky,
right.
And that's really why they split up. Sorry, Clancy, I didn't listen to you, but I'm sure you were a good detective.
Remember, Rod Argent was in the Zombies.
Yes,
remember the Zombies.
I think the first Argent album sort of sounded a bit zombie-ish.
Yes.
Who was in Zombie? The Zombies. I listened to a podcast recently with the guy from the Zombies.
I think I only know Rod Argent. I don't think I know anybody else. No. Somebody will tell us, no doubt. But
Colin, someone.
I'll just have a look for you. They were quite an interesting band. I quite like some of their stuff.
Colin Bluntstone. I think he was in. Was he in them? Anyway, I listened to a podcast with him. He was quite entertaining. Rory Gallagher again played. Support from Jackie Linton, played on December 1st, 1974, and wow, he was touring quite a lot there because he played the next day as well. Sorry, so I haven't updated that. So it's two nights from Rory. Then good, That's all I can say. I can't not want to go to this gig, because I would love to go to that gig. Yeah. And the next gig on even the very more. Next night, even better for me, I think. Yeah. Well, imagine what Rory Gallagher would have been like if he was in Bad Company. Whoa. Here's the thing. Alan in Vancouver. Thank you,
Alan. Right. In Vancouver. Sorry, Alan in Vancouver.
Sorry, mate. Didn't want to upset Boots. It's kind of comment he comes out with.
It was a typical Boots comment and caught you out there. Caught us both out.
Usually puts a couple of boots. I should have.
Aye. Yeah. Hey. Oh, look. He's actually got the boots on today.
Oh, he does. There he is.
Well, I'm called the Friar and Dr. Muir now.
He's in the house. Yes. Probably got his slippers on though. Bad Company.
The big slippers, mate.
Oh, two big slippers.
Yeah.
Bad Company. Dustin Bennett played on December the 3rd, 1974.
Yeah.
Brilliant. Why? These are gigs that I'd love to have gone to see.
Yeah,
not sure, but I read that Dustin Bennett was a bit of a one-man show.
Yeah.
And not the right thing for the Bad Company crowd. But yeah, Bad Company, I love them. I couldn't go. That's it. I mean,
what age were you then? You'd be about seven.
I was seven.
Oh, yes. Come on, what was your old man doing? Your old man should have had you at that gig.
He should have.
That's terrible. It's child abuse. Was it
Tuesday night?
That's child abuse.
December 74. What was I doing? I was sitting not a mile away from there.
Yeah, that's like ECDC coming to town and me not taking Bertie. I mean, it's just child abuse. Yeah, I'm going to have a word with him. If he comes in, I'm going to have a word with him.
Yeah, well, he's really busy doing something.
Aye.
Yeah. Mate, I could have looked out the window and seen the Apollo. I could have. Almost. If I'd looked out the kitchen window, yeah. Anyway. At Osprey Heights.
Oh, my God.
It wasn't Osprey Heights.
It's going to start singing, "I belong to Glasgow, you know, Glasgow town." Come on.
I don't know. I like the Billy Connolly song.
Ah, me too. That's a good song.
So Uriah Heep played with Tim Rose. Tim Rose, that name sounds familiar. Played November the 27th, 1975. I listened to Uriah Heep. Let It Roll I think the album was Let It Roll. And they, oh no, I'm thinking of some other gig on this list. Anyway, it's a good album, I think. But good show. Uriah Heep, what they got? Guitar, bass, drums, Hammond organ, singer. Brilliant. You can't really go wrong with that stuff.
I mean, they were probably never quite got to where they would like to have got, but they were big for a very brief period. I mean, they played massive gigs in the States for a few years.
Yeah.
Some great songs.
I think they've sold like 20 million albums.
Yeah, they've done very well, but it was a very brief thing, and then they... Remember, they were one of the last gigs at the Apollo as well. But I wish I'd been at that.
Yeah. Well, that was when they were more in their
Deep Purple sort of...
No, that was more like in their AOR Foreigner stage.
Oh, right. Oh, yeah.
That's a brilliant... I love that album because it's quite like modern when Bad Company didn't have Paul Rogers.
They had other
like that sort of... Great. There's a song in there. It's a brilliant song. Brilliant song on that last. Anyway, I can't remember. Okay, so I can't remember. It's too early in the morning for me. Uriah Heep, 1975. This is Bamford saying my very first gig. Brilliant, Ian. Yeah,
great gig.
How was your ears after it?
Whoops.
What are you listening to there?
It was just I hit the wrong button.
That's your favourite song of the year, isn't it? Right. So Cliff Richard appeared in the set list, on the gig list.
Yeah.
November 29th,
1975.
So didn't listen to you, but I'm pretty sure he put on a great show.
I'm pretty sure he did. And I'm delighted I wasn't there.
Caravan played December 3rd, 1975. Didn't listen to Caravan either, sorry. But
they're all right, you know. I quite like Caravan.
Yeah. Oh, Cliff again. Showing up the next year in November 27, 1976. He must have cranked out lots of Christmas songs. I mean, he's got the Mistletoe and Wine later on, but
he's done it for about 20 odd years, hasn't he? He's done loads of them.
Yeah. I mean, he's a good singer. I enjoy him. He's a good singer. Yeah. Loudon Wainwright the third played in November.
Not sure I agree with that.
1976.
He's talking nonsense again.
Mate, you have to be open.
Yes, but not so open as your brain falls out and you become a Clive Richards fan.
You're not learning anything from what you watch.
I'm not learning
what
anything.
You talk about on your own bloody show.
You're
not
right.
Learning
not,
it.
Not a thing. But wait a minute. Yeah. Learning to the point of being a Clive Richards fan, that's quite a step, you know?
Yeah. Well, that's a step too far for you.
That's a step I don't want to take. That's the step I don't want to take. Too far.
You don't know. You might get to an age and go, oh, I think I'll put on Devil Woman.
Let's have a wee listen to Cliff. No.
Look, no. That's your childhood there, sorry.
Aye. And maybe your man. I mean, one of these days I might be able to listen to the God of Rock. Sorry, the voice of Rock. But but Cliff Richard.
You've been traumatized. Anyway, Loudon Wainwright the third played November 28th, 1976. I listened to this album.
Did you?
Quite liked it. Quite liked it. It was a bit mixed up.
Yeah.
It was sort of rocky then. It was
sorry, who are we talking about here? I was Loudon,
talking about Loudon Wainwright.
Oh right, okay, yeah. Very clever songwriter.
I don't know. Some of the songs are I didn't get the jokey song. I mean, yeah. Fine if you want to do a jokey song, but yeah, you're good. I mean, who am I to tell Loudon what to do?
Oh, here he goes again.
Good on you, mate. You're having a go. Go on. Good on you.
He was in Marsh.
What?
He was in Marsh.
Yes.
That's some rubbish trivia for you. That was his best album when he stood there in Marsh and didn't do anything, didn't sing.
All right, okay. It was his best thing. The Marshall Tucker Band, Bonnie Bramlett, and Grinderswitch played on December the 1st, 1976. I posted this on the group. Yeah. It was in support of an album called Southern Rock or something. I forgot the name of it. But from the Capricorn record label. I listened to them. I quite like Bonnie Bramlett is a sort of American version of Maggie Bell.
Oh, really?
Same kind of not as rocky as Maggie Bell, but the same kind of lineage. If you she's a blues sort of singer, but she didn't go as hard into the blues. Yeah, there they are. There's the lads there. And listen to Grinderswitch, possibly the best name of a band ever.
Ah, it's good, isn't it? I like it as well.
I think what their song, something I can't remember what it was called, but it was John Peel used it. Something the blues was a John Peel sort of soundtrack that he used, I think. The Marshall Tucker Band, good band. Sort of just underneath second division, I'd say, Southern rock band, but great nonetheless. I mean,
I tell you what, I think maybe they had done some of that Southern interbreeding because there's Grinderswitch, they look very like the Marshall Tucker Band.
and Grinderswitch, when they did the gig, Grinderswitch just kept, they were first on, and then they played, Bonnie Bramlett played, and she just came on and did her stuff.
Ah, right, very good.
Switch playing.
Very good.
But it was a good, it's good record, and I think Jack has it on his rescued recording this week as one of the downloads, the Marshall Tucker Band. Yeah, I downloaded that. It's pretty good. They're a good band. Good rock band.
I listened to the rescue. It's good.
Yeah, and Grinderswitch are a good band too. Kind of a bluesy rock band. It's really good. Right. I enjoyed them. That would have been a good gig. But I would have gone to that. The Doubleners, didn't listen to them, but I'm pretty sure they would have been turned out. They would have been a big crowd for the Doubleners. Steve Hillage and Nova. Oh, sorry, I didn't mention. Thursday, December the 2nd. Where are we up to? December the 2nd, 1976. That was the Doubleners. Steve Hillage and Nova played Friday, December the 3rd, 1976. Once again, I failed to do my homework and didn't listen to Steve Hillage. Although I should.
He played with Gong and stuff, so he was quite, you know, in demand as a. He was a very good, you know, prog type.
Prog type.
Yeah.
He's in the prog types.
Yeah. Right. Well, he did Tubular Bells. He did. He toured by Mike Oldfield, people like that. Yeah. He's really good. I mean, he's very well respected in the guitar scene.
Right. Okay. All right. Status quo. Three nights, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, November the 27th, 28th, 29th, 1977, touring Rocking All Over the World album. I listened to this album. I thought...
That's cool.
There's a couple of songs on it that are a bit... Yeah, they're fine. Hold You Back, Dirty Water...
Yeah,
and Rocking All Over the World are the standout tracks for me. Yeah. They had a new producer on that album, who's different from a guy called Pip Williams, who's a new guy. So I cleaned up their sound and everything. But yeah, it would have been a great show.
Back then, absolutely. I'd love to have seen them in 77. That would have been brilliant.
77, I mean... Mm-hmm. I love Alan
Lancaster.
Lancaster, thank you. Alan Lancaster's voice.
Ah, me too.
On the live album. Well, on the album. So you forget that he sang a lot of the songs. Because, I mean, I've seen Cole after he left as well. And Rick Parfitt generally did his songs.
Yeah.
Yeah. Great singer. Great, good band. Good boogie band.
Cannot deny
the Hairy Chesters.
Underground, overground, one. Sorry. And we've got Dave's telling us, Dave Wilson saying, Steve Hillage also supported Queen at Hyde Park back in the 70s.
Wow.
Didn't know that either. And here's a sort of standard Boots quote, status quo, were great on Jim Fixer. I'm sure they were.
They were good on Coronation Street as well.
Oh, I remember that.
The next, but Three Nights, Status Quo, obviously they loved Glasgow and obviously Glasgow loved them.
Not according to Uncle Bulgaria. Anyway, right, move on.
Grumpy Bulgaria, isn't it?
God. Francis Rossi.
The Jam, New Hearts, The Jolt. Played the very next night on November the 30th, 1977, Wednesday, school night. I'm sure a lot of the school kids were at the Jam. Listen to the Jam, and I listened to a bit of the Jolt, but I didn't listen to the New Hearts. New Hearts fans. And I think I listened to some live stuff from the Apollo from the Jam. Great, good band. I think this time this was their last. Was this their last album as the Jam? No, couldn't be. Wouldn't it be? No, it wouldn't have been.
No, not at all. No.
But enjoyed their sounds, the sounds of the Jam, and I listened to some of the Jolt, the Jam. Not sure if that was intentional, but
might have been.
The Jam heard the Jolt and said, that's a good name. But they were, I think the Jolt were from, think one of our, maybe one of our members or a couple of our members were in the joke.
Oh, brilliant.
A guy called Coates.
Oh, these are the guys from Wishaw. Yeah.
Well, they played in Wishaw. I think they played in Wishaw a lot. They played at the Crown in Wishaw. Wishaw.
Formed in Wishaw in 1976.
Yes, but I think they were from Shorts or somewhere. Shorts.
Oh, right, okay.
And surrounds. South Lanarkshire. They were good. They were all right.
Did I not see them at the Crown?
I doubt you'd be seeing them at the Crown, mate.
Really?
What age would you have been?
I'd be about -4 or something.
Yeah, 1977. You're firing up to the Crown. Can you let me in and see the joke, please?
He's a half and a half.
Yeah, right. I don't think you did. They might have played it.
It was hemorrhoids I saw at the Crown. That's it was, the hemorrhoids.
The Crown in where? Curlew?
Curlew.
I think I was there.
I think you were, yeah. And we saw them at I'm meeting another Victory V.
We certainly saw them at the Heathery.
Saw them at the Heathery. I remember the Heathery. They scared the bejesus out of me. Them and Dumpy's. Oh, yeah. Bloody hell. What a nightmare. Anyway.
The hemorrhoids were similar and if not scarier than Dumpy's listing up.
Right.
I used to think there's a band and they're from Shorts.
Aye.
And they play music? What? Wild. People play music in Lanarkshire. Make actually bands in Lanarkshire.
Yeah.
Anyway. Nazareth. We reminisce. We reminisce again. Nazareth Marseille played Friday, December 2nd, 1977.
Yeah.
You can't really fault Nazareth. Great band.
Why didn't they get bigger, though?
They were pretty big, mate. They were massive in America. They were massive.
I think they should have been bigger. I think they were fantastic. I really feel
for them. I've said this to you before. Read Billy
Rankin.
Thank you. Billy Rankin. See, my brain's not working at the moment. I stayed up too late. Billy Rankin's website. Great information on Billy Rankin's website about Nazareth and the shenanigans that went on there and all the tours and great. Good website, good guy, good guitarist. You're a good man, Billy.
Like the Apollo.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if he liked it, but he played it.
Well, he said he did.
All right, okay. He played it. Who's that, Marseille?
Yeah.
All right.
Come on. You're quite impressed.
I'm quite impressed.
Looks like Big Biff from Saxon there on the right-hand side.
It does. It looks like a bit of a Joel Lynn Turner guy in the middle there.
In the middle? Yeah, it does.
From the right.
Can't you see? I think that guy, he'll be walking into walls and stuff, that boy. Look at him.
Yeah.
Hello? Yeah.
They're having fun.
These guys were cool back then.
They were fun. They were having fun. Yeah, yeah. Devo, supported by Doll by Doll. This was the We Are Not Men, We Are Devo tour from Devo. I listened to the live album. Brilliant. Loved it. Great. And I'm sure people who... Well, they are weird, but they're good. They're good.
They're good weird. No, they're good weird. I think they're great weird.
You know. Just
very creative. Very, very different the way they...
Wacky. Wacky. Very wacky.
There's quite a good performance of them on the YouTubes, and it's pretty good. Yeah. You know, they're probably in their 60s or 70s, but they're pretty good.
Yeah, well, the Whip It, I Can Get No Satisfaction, and Girl You Want, what I was listening to. And the album, Uncontrollable Urge. Great. Really driving. God, I loved it. It was great. It's a good album. Surprises me, all the stuff that I've never listened to and go, oh, that is good.
I know, honestly. It's quite embarrassing.
Yeah. No, it's not embarrassing. It's just what you're listening to. Good.
I think it's embarrassing.
I listened to Doll by Doll. I can't really, nothing really, you know, nothing really stood out. It was all right. It was music. Nothing really was terrible. Nothing really was fantastic. I'm sure you were great. They must have been okay because Devo wanted them to support.
Yeah, they must have been.
Maybe that's, Sorry?
They must have been okay.
Yeah. David Essex, I listened to the album from this tour. What was it called? It was something about wizards. Imperial Wizard, that's what it was called.
Well done. Imperial Wizard.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that's what I was gonna say. That Dionne Warwick album. That Dionne Warwick album was touring was called Just Being Myself, right?
Right.
And all the tracks on it were pre-recorded. She didn't really have much to do about it. And yeah. So she didn't really do much of the creative input, and it was called Just Being Myself.
Ah.
So it wasn't much of herself. It was much of the songwriter.
No, you should have said that back in the moment when we were talking about
I always noticed it because I looked, I see my playlist here that I was watching.
Confusing the viewer here. Confusing the viewer, mate. I mean, we're talking about this beautiful man here.
We're all right. David Essex. It was all wizards and...
Fwah.
Yeah.
I can't be doing him.
Well, he's too pretty, isn't he? That's what it is.
Aye. I like this one with the motorbike.
Yeah,
Silver Green Machine. That was a good song. I like that.
That was a good song.
Yeah. Aye. And he used to dress like a farmer. Remember, back in the 90s, he would dress like a farmer. It was almost like Wardrobe Gummidge type, the way he would dress.
Oh, yeah.
I remember that.
But he was dressing like a biker.
Yeah, it's very odd. He did sort of some West End stuff as well, didn't he? So, I mean, he did. Very, he's had a great career.
Oh, he's had a great career. He's a good singer. He's a singer that can sing. Surprise me with his vocal range. He's a famous singer. Why would it surprise me? Anyway, good.
There's plenty of famous singers don't have any vocal range.
That's true. That's true.
I know. Yeah. Aye. That's
true. Gene Pitney's not one of them, though.
Nah.
He's a great singer.
Yeah.
Gene Pitney. Is he a bit of a rock and roller? Sorry, I didn't look up Gene.
Kind of, yeah. I mean, it was kind of its time. But yeah, he was. Aye, he had a great attitude.
Gene Pitney.
Oh,
I mean, I just remember Gene Pitney from the TV show Tutti Frutti. There's a bit of a... Who do you think we are? Gene Pitney.
Pitney, aye.
We're not Gene Pitney. I think that was Bomba that delivered that line for all the... For all the nerds. Dr. Feelgood played November the 27th, 1979.
Marvelous.
I listened to Dr. Feelgood. Good stuff. Good boogie band. Boogie pub rock band. Good band. Queen played two nights. Friday, November the 30th, and Saturday, December the 1st, 1979. Is this the Sheer Heart Attack album?
No idea.
No idea. Come on, chat. Let us know.
I'm sure somebody will know. I think it was 79.
I didn't listen to this show, but I listened to a wee clip of them from the Apollo last night. Obviously, great band, Height of the Powers. I think this was their last show at the Apollo. So they moved on. They went up. Up the ladder of success to begin
the live album in 79, didn't they? The Killers album. Oh, I remember that, but I don't know what else. I mean, I'm sure Tommy or something will know that. I'm just not.
No, good. Obviously, good band. Hairy Chester.
Yeah, it's crazy tour. Live Killers was the album. There you go. Hey.
Thanks, Tommy. Joe Jackson, supported by the original Mirrors and the Photos, played December the 3rd, 1979. I listened to Joe Jackson last night. Surprised me that I liked it. You know, I do like his what is it? Is She Really Going Out With Him? That was the only song I knew, really.
Yeah.
And then there's a song on there called Time on My Hands, I think it's called. Which was covered by Anthrax. Great album, great song, good band. And I was surprised how rocky it was.
Right.
Or guitar orientated.
Right.
don't know if it's rocky, but it's a lot of guitar. Good. Yeah. Didn't listen to the original Mirrors or the Photos. Sorry, guys. But Joe Jackson, bit of a revelation for me. So I will investigate him further. Yes, played two nights, Thursday, November the 27th and 28th. This was Arena? Arena tour? Arena album? Drama. This was when Trevor Horn stepped in to do the vocals there. I think this wasn't a great gig at the Apollo, these two nights. I think Trevor Horn was struggling a bit vocally. I mean, if you happen to cover John Anderson.
No.
If you haven't match him or even get near him, he must be a great singer. And Trevor Horn's a great producer and a great guitarist and a great musician. I'm not sure he's as great a singer. He did okay in the album. The album's
okay.
I mean, some of the songs in that are great.
Well, they're more accessible than they were earlier on, aren't they? Obviously, he's got a pop sensibility about him, but
Chris Squire's
brilliant.
Oh, Chris Squire's banging out the bass on that.
Unbelievable.
But he's way up high. Brilliant. Yeah.
There was a Trevor Horn tour about, it was probably just before COVID's.
Yeah.
And loads of my friends went to it, and they all said it was just fantastic. You know, it was him with a whole lot of guests, including Steve Hogarth from Marillion.
Was he doing songs that he had produced and everything?
Aye, he was. And the whole range.
So he probably did 90216. 90210. 90216. I enjoyed that album. Yeah, good set, but I'm sure that I didn't think the gig lived up to the.
No, there's been quite a lot of negativity about it on the website and on the group.
Yeah. Sad Cafe played November the 29th, 1980, supported by Monroe. I listened to Sad Cafe, a double live album. Great. Loved it.
I never quite got them.
I think we were just 1980, we were just a bit too young
just
for that.
Too young, yeah.
It's quite wordy. So we went into words.
I like Motorhead. Yeah.
We were just being stupid. Yeah. But yeah, I liked it. Loved it. Good album. Good, great live album. What was it?
Everyday Hearts or something, wasn't it?
Everyday Hearts. What a song. Brilliant song.
Yeah, good song.
But he's a good singer. He's a great singer, obviously, because he went on to be Mike and the Mechanics.
He's a dude.
I think he did some of his own.
It was terrible when he died. I remember he died 20 years ago. It was awful when Paul Young died. It was very, very sad.
Sky played December the 30th, 1980.
Fair to say, the most popular band on the website?
Well, I don't know.
Loved by everyone.
Loved man and dog.
Yes.
All creeds and colours. Sky appealed to them.
Dogs. It's like the play up high.
Dogs are like, oh. Yeah. Anyway, sorry, prattling on now. That'd have been, if you like Sky, that'd have been a great gig. If you didn't, you'd have hated it. It'd be murder. The Pretenders, again, another revelation for me. Their second album I listened to, Pretenders 2, it's called.
Yep.
Great. Talk of the Town. What a song. Good songs on that. Rocky. Oh, man. Why did I dismiss these people? Because you only hear the singles and you can't be bothered.
Ah, that's right. That is the reason, isn't it? Because you don't get to hear any of their proper.
Yeah,
I had an argument. Well, not an argument. I had a fiery discussion with a musician who'd had a hit in the 70s, and I said to him, "I think the singles were actually, because his music's excellent, but you would never go near his music because he did pop songs, unless you were into pop music." But he didn't agree. He saw it as we make the money from the singles that allows us to make the music we want to make, which is a fair cop.
That's what he did. Well, he on the live album, he goes, we didn't think this song was anything special. And then he said 500,000 of you people changed our minds. So he must have sold like 500,000 at the time.
Absolutely.
So, yeah. So yeah, it's a good song, good album, good live album, good band. So if you feel like investigating Sad Cafe, go for the live album. It's great. Pretenders, that's where we were in the Pretenders, actually. Pretenders, good band. I'm going to listen to them again. Michael Schenker Group with Vandenberg played December the 2nd, 1982. Now, I'm not sure if I went to this gig because our friend, Colin Tonner, he was a massive Michael Schenker fan. Massive. And I don't know if I... Because he definitely went to that gig. Definitely and I don't know if him telling me about it so many times has made me think that I was there. I have to... But I did see Michael Schenker at the Apollo, and I'm pretty sure I saw Vandenberg, so I might have been there. But 1982, I don't think I was there.
Yeah.
But maybe telling me about it so many times that...
I think I'm the same. Yeah. I saw him at the Playhouse. I never saw him at the Apollo, but I remember the recording from them doing the Reading set. Remember when they played at Reading? I don't know if they were the headliner or they were the second in the headline. Yeah. Absolutely brilliant.
Yeah. Brilliant. Well, I think on this...
Like Lost Her Eyes.
On this tour, it was on the album, it was Graham Bonnet singing, but Schenker sacked him. Sacked him about a day after the album was released, or something, and then got Gary Barden back in.
Famously, very scared to go on stage, wasn't he? He was very nervous.
Gary Barden?
Yeah, terrified. He hated it.
Is he? Oh, okay.
Stage fright, big time.
That's a shame because he's a good singer.
He's not a bad singer at all. Hank. He used to get quite a lot of abuse, I remember. But
he's good. He's fine. And Vandenberg, that was. Adrian Vandenberg.
My little brother. That was me doing a David Coverdale.
Oh, right, okay, sorry.
You know, David Coverdale falls in love with everybody who's in his band. But you remember the Tokyo Tapes thing that he did?
Yes, that's very good, that one.
Yeah. Absolutely brilliant.
Yeah. But Vandenberg played in... when I was doing a bit of research last night, he might have auditioned for Thin Lizzy.
Really?
That would have been a good...
See that? Yeah, I can see that.
Scott Gorham and him would have been pretty good.
No, I can see it,
But I don't know why he didn't... Obviously, I don't know why he didn't get the gig. But, he has an unusual technique in guitar. Right. So, I don't know if I saw it. I'm unsure. But I do like MSG. Quite good rock band. Yeah. Oh, my little brother.
They'll sack him tomorrow.
He's had more members of...
Oh, it's ridiculous.
Whitesnake. Whitesnake's got must have had 100 people in it or something.
There's only one common. I mean, I love the guy.
And always make sure that everyone in your band sings really well.
Yeah. That tells me David Coverdale.
Yeah. But he's a great singer too, but he does surround himself by other good singers too. YNT and Rock Goddess played Sunday, November the 27th, 1983. Whew, that's a school night for us.
All right, we were there.
It was a Sunday night.
All right.
That was a good gig. I remember that gig.
Despite the hair, look at the hair, look at the state of the haircuts. What? Whoever thought that was cool?
Well, they did. There's a hairy chest right there. Come on.
There is. Right. On show.
Dave Menichetti, the guy with the lighter coloured hair in the middle there. And that guy on the... Is that guy on the right? Is that the guy on the left? Who's that?
It's his brother.
Is that Y&T? That's not the Y&T I saw.
I think it is.
No, I saw the guy, the drummer was Leonard Hayes. He's a short guy.
I know who he is.
Of a substantial build. And that's what I remember. I remember his bass drum in his solo when he did drum solo.
That was YNT, but that was a different version. Hang on, I'll just show you.
That must have been your 80s.
Aye.
Late 80s Summertime Girls version.
Oh, God, you remember that? I hated
that. That's a great song.
They went all Dave Lee Roth, and that was the end of it.
That's a great song.
Remember the robot had that bloody... I mean, they tried every trick in the book, didn't they?
Yeah, there you go. There's Leonard right in the middle there.
Yeah.
Good, yeah, good. He was...
Right in the middle of four folk.
Is that Phil?
Special maths when you're dealing with Andy. What?
Yeah. Oh, sorry. No, they were a good band.
They were a great band. His brother died recently, well, a few years ago now, didn't he?
That's the same. And Leonard Hayes is no longer with us either, I don't think. They were a good, great band. I loved them. I loved YNT. Rock Goddess. Wasn't much of a fan of Rock Goddess, but I went to see YNT basically. But Rock Goddess were fine. But I didn't her singing always hurt my throat when she sang. Because I don't know, it just felt like it was hurting her throat. So I was like,
she couldn't sing. What you're saying is she can't sing to save herself.
No, I'm saying she could sing, but she forced it. She made it to me, it was too hard. She could sing. She could sing, mate. So Paul Young played November 29th, 1984. I listened to two Paul Young albums from the era, No Parley and... forgotten what it's called. Anyway, probably called Paul Young. But I did No Parley and Secret of Association. Oh. I love Paul Young. He's a great singer. Sometimes let down by his songs, and probably you're going to say something about one of the worst gigs you ever saw.
Ever. In my whole life, one of the worst gigs I've ever been at. Absolutely.
You can't have a good night.
He can't sing to save himself. And the backing group were amazing, but he was terrible.
Yeah. But you can't have a good night every night, mate.
He needs to have one out there. Come on. he had this really weak, whatever I
think. He might have been sick.
I could have given him one of my Victory V's right enough.
That's right. He could have.
Right. But... I just thought he was... There was a brilliant guy. One of the backing singers was absolutely brilliant. He was outstandingly good.
Uh-huh.
But Paul Young was just... Yeah.
Well, he might have been sick, so you never know.
He may well have been.
He had a bit of trouble with his voice.
He did. I remember seeing him on Tiswatch, and he couldn't sing that on there either. So I'm seeing a trend.
Too early in the morning, Tiswatch.
Maybe.
Too overcome by Sally.
It was.
Yeah. Gary Newman, Hokum, and
good luck.
Hoba. Your father's away to your father's away to work with that and his sandwiches. Anyway, Hoba and Larry Lober.
Spam. Yeah.
Played December 3rd, 1984. I think I saw some people saying that this wasn't on the Facebook page that this wasn't his best album.
Yeah, as well.
I didn't listen to that album, but and I didn't listen to the two support acts. Sorry, but
I was a fan of Barry.
Are you a fan of Gary? Barry Newman. That's his brother.
Less on
Barry. Barry.
Who the fuck is Barry? When I was attending the Fish gig last week, I met my friend afterwards, who is a massive sort of fan of Gary Newman and all that sort of stuff.
Uh-huh.
Barry Newman. And apparently one night he was playing in Newman was playing in Leamington. It's a really cute little place called the Assembly there. It's really nice. And people like Iggy Pop have played there, so it's had a few good gigs. It's not very big or anything, but it's about 1,000 people. But anyway, and all the equipment blew, but the place had sold out. So he came on with his band and the old acoustic guitars, and he said it was one of the best gigs he's ever been at in his life.
Brilliant.
Yeah, he said it was absolutely brilliant. He had never, didn't even know that they could play that sort of music, but they just did it off the top of their head. So the guy's obviously a pro, you know?
Yeah.
A pro.
Yeah. I mean, he's a good musician.
Yeah, it's some great stuff. Absolutely brilliant. So let's see what folk are saying. There's a few comments we haven't quite managed to.
Sorry,
you were battering through at a hell of a rate, you know? Here's Tony saying, I was at MSG and YNT. Great gigs. Agree with you, Scott. I still have the Reading tape. I recommend, if you've not heard that, I think, Tony, it might be on an album, I think. Well worth listening to, because, by God, he was on form that night. The whole band were. And, of course, it was Alex Harvey band, backing band, wasn't it?
Almost. Yeah. Chris Glenn and Ted McKenna.
Two of them. And Ian saying, was Vandenberg a hairdresser in the West End? Well, he certainly could use his hairspray, as Boots said. There's lots and lots of hairspray in that. What else has been said? What are you going to say?
I was going to say, he did this weird thing on his guitar where he would bar the string and then play a scale on the bar.
Aye.
And I don't know if I saw that or Colin told me that. I don't know. But that was his style of soloing. So it was a different sort of style.
Aye.
Yeah.
They're back together again, I think. Back together. They are back together, I think, Vandenberg as a band. I think I just saw touring again. And but no, he was an unusual guitar player, definitely. I mean, he kind of, Colin liked that sort of classic Schenker type guitar player.
Yeah.
Doesn't like that, you know. But no, Colin always liked him. And here's somebody saying, and quite right too, Paul Young was far better than the Q-tips, far than the soul stuff. I agree. Just needed some Victory V's. Troubles in, Rockers in. Hello, James. Welcome to the show. Good to see you, mate. Saw Paul Young here, and his voice was gone. Yeah, double bill with Midgeur, who was great. Yeah, yeah. That's an interesting double bill, isn't it? Paul Young, I would have thought Midgeur would have headlined that. Just shows you what I know. Anyway. And there's James McAvity making a really intelligent comment. The Dubliners. Thanks, James. That's a great contribution. Thanks for joining the show this week. No idea what he's talking about. And there we have it. I don't know what that was about. Sorry, Boots. Anything else?
Paul Young is a bit kick. Well,
a bit kick. I agree with you, James. You're allowed to have opinions. You might not be right, but you're allowed to have opinions. And if people don't like it, they can go and jump off a bridge. Anyway, right.
No, they can't. They don't jump off bridges anymore, mate.
They're not. Actually, James just redeemed himself. MSG, is that not a food additive? It's actually quite
good.
Anyway, so thanks very much, mate. Well done. You got through the whole thing. And you did it quite well, I thought. So what will we do next? I think I know what we're going to do next, actually. I'm going to do this because I might talk about it. I'll just do this before the socials, Andy, because I just want to get this in before we...
Hi, mate. I thought we were having someone on this week.
We were, but I made a mistake, and I just wanted to apologise. There's two of you. If you're watching and you're not in the huff for me, I'm very sorry. There was a problem with my diary scheduling thing, and I just totally missed them. I'm really sorry. After me banging on about it for months, then people come onto it, and I let them down. So I'm really sorry. I'm present annoyed with myself. So please accept my apologies. I've been in touch, hopefully, and you've seen my emails and grovelling emails, but... It was just a technology problem. I missed the emails. So it was actually the schedule I missed rather than the emails. So my sincere apologies. This is a bit about, we want you to think about filming your memories and sending them in, because there's nothing better. If you've been watching the show for the last few months, you've seen some cracking videos made by people who don't make videos. They just tell us their stories. It's absolutely brilliant. So please, if you need any help, give us a bell. Drop me a DM and I'll help you, and I will show up. I definitely will show up. During the event on the 17th, we're having our night out, which we'll talk about again later. I'm going to have my camera with me until I have to put it somewhere safe because I've had too much Guinness. But I'll be filming people if they want to do their stories on the night in Lauders. So I hope we can catch up with some of you there. So apologies once again for my bloody diary letting me down. So I should have checked it. My problem. So, next up, mate, let's do the socials, eh? I think we should do the socials. You always like that now with the new... With the new- Have you been able to make any sense of the socials?
Ah, kind of getting there.
Good.
we have now, this week it was 49 people joined. Thank you very much for joining. Hope there's some new viewers there.
That's been a year, at least 50, on average. I mean, I've not done the maths, but it's on average 50 people every week for a year.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it's good. It's great.
It's incredible.
It's good. It's good that and what I'm enjoying now is more people are posting stuff that is relevant. That is relevant.
Yes.
Some folk post some stuff that's not, but so there was a few people this week posting their ticket collections, which is very nice.
Magic.
Yeah, I always liked looking at them. Okay, so there's 49 people. Joined. We now have 10,407 members. This week we had 44,000 views of stuff on the site, which is remarkable.
Unbelievable.
And 890 people posted and commented. Although it does say there was 132 posts, 1,500 comments, and 4,000. Nearly 5,000 comments, reactions, like, you know, thumbs up, smiley faces, poos, that kind of thing.
Yeah. Fantastic. Yeah. It's amazing. It's a huge number of people getting involved. It's just terrific. Really good. Mm. Really, really good. Just let me check the chat before we do the next bit. No, just folk abusing each other.
Sorry, I was incorrect. There's been 60 people. 60 people.
Even more than 50. Okay.
New update. 60
people. We're going to play some music now. This is a bit unusual, this, because I'm not sure how many people have heard. And I mentioned earlier it's going to be Man. Now, I was really taken by the recording of this. If you go into our YouTube channel, www.youtube.com/GlasgowApolloLife, you'll see that we're collating as much of the material, the live material from the Apollo as we can. And it's growing every week, mate. There's more and more appearing every week. And of course, I've got to mention at this point, the guys over at Rescued Recordings, Jack, Stephen and Phil, because they do an amazing job, and they've unearthed so many rare recordings, unheard recordings over the years.
Yeah.
I'm not sure about this Man one. I think it's just appeared. I don't know if it was to do with Rescued Recordings, but obviously it will end up on the Rescued Recordings desk, and you'll be able to get a copy of it via Jack. But this, I listened to the whole thing, and not really my type of music, but there was just something about them that made me keep listening. And you can tell there's not a huge crowd at this, but a lot of their songs are quite long, mate. So what I've done is I've just taken 5 minutes of one rather than...
taken 5 minutes
of one. It was a 12-minute epic, but that was one of the shorter ones. And this is called Many Are Called, But Few Get Up. So this is Man playing the Glasgow Apollo back in the 1970s.
The next song we're going to do now is... one from an album we did some time ago. This is Do You Like It Here Now? Are You Settling In? All right. And it was also on Live at the Paget Rooms, which some of you might have been able to get hold of. This is a song we wrote. This is called Many Are Called, But Few Get Up. Thank you very much. Thank you.
What's that drummer doing?
Doing lots of paradiddles.
What the hell? I think he was in rehearsals there.
Yeah.
But what did you think of that?
Well, from what I heard, it was a bit bonkers.
It was mad, wasn't it? Yeah. I quite enjoyed them. I mean, I wouldn't choose to listen. I'm going to go and listen to Man. But no,
I wouldn't choose to listen.
No, but. Yeah, I mean, there's some abuse, which is what you'd expect, but
yeah.
And then there's Boots is saying, "I take it back, Scott. You can play fish." So you didn't like that then, Boots? Well, we're on this show. We're committed to doing lots of different types of music, even Welsh music, and
even Welsh music.
Right, James says. It's like prog with a wee bit of Welshisms added to it, which you can't whack. Moan St. David and the mighty dragon that was slayed. What are you on? Have you been drinking Tizer? I think you've been drinking Tizer. That's what it is. It's E-numbers. They're having an impact again on James. But anyway, that was Man. We're going to continue our quest to find different types of music to play on the show, whether we like it or not. There's a couple of people liked it, which was nice.
Yeah.
You could hear that in the recording that when they said the name of that song, there was quite a loud. I quite like this. Ian's riffing off it. Many are called, but few are frozen. That's quite good. But somebody here saying, I think it's Alan saying, he loved the track. And he thought that Jack had already put it up on a Monday, Friday. Maybe he does. I'm not up to date 100% with what he's doing. If only he could find Wishbone Ash. Yeah, absolutely. I think the Wishbone Ash ones will turn up eventually. I think there might be some of that rather than...
Well, I think there's a Wishbone Ash album already.
There is. I'm sure you're right, mate. And Bond's saying, we'd rather listen to White Noise. Not your type of music then, mate. But and then finally, this is Welsh Magic Mushrooms. There you go. My goodness. The usual standard of comments. Very good. So, we're going to finish with an epic because it's our 50th show. It's going to be the whole of the Marillion gig. No, it's not. But anyway.
So switch off now.
So switch off now, but it's not. I wouldn't do that to you. I would. One of these nights I'm going to. We must do a greatest hits. We should do a festive 20 or something, Andy, with all the different music we've played over the year, because I think that would go down quite well. Anyway, I'm just thinking out loud. Here we go. Just to remind you, and thanks for a couple of people that bought us a coffee today. Thank you very much. That really is appreciated. I actually spent the money that you put into the coffee fund on some software today, Canva. So forgive me for not spending it on coffee or alcohol. But nevertheless, this is why we need the money. Yeah. It really helps us. I'm sorry, mate. If you want your coffees, I'll send them over to you by courier. I've just seen somebody come in called Mike Hobday. Mike Hobday is the guy I was telling you the stories about earlier. Mike, I've been talking about you, mate. And it was a nice thing. I was telling them about your Mike, Gary Newman experience. We're now calling him Barry Newman. We decided he's called Barry Newman rather than... But I was telling them what you thought about getting the guitars out that night when you saw him in Leamington. So thanks for joining us. That's great. Anyway, thanks for the beers. Thanks for the coffees. I really appreciate them. As Andy said earlier in the chat, there's a sale on in the T-shirts department. Is there?
I'm not sure if it's still on, but...
Oh, I think it might be.
All right, okay.
I think I saw that they've extended it. Don't hold me to that. Okay. Have a look. I was flying around like a lunatic earlier today, and I might not necessarily have got that right. But thanks for your support, folks. We really appreciate it.
Yeah.
So, what to end with, mate, for the 50th show? Well,
I don't know.
It was Nearly Bad Company. Nearly Bad Company. Because we both love Bad Company. And, of course, it was Nearly Thin Lizzy. We've played a lot of Thin Lizzy on the show, so we thought, well, let's not do that. And then... the professor posted something on there about Zeppelin back in the day. And there's obviously the 1970s, 72, 73, whatever it is. 73 recording that turned out. two hours, 40 minutes of Led Zeppelin from the Greens Playhouse, rediscovered just 2 years ago. So, and I decided that because it was our 50th, I just played whatever the bloody hell I wanted to. Now, the recording isn't amazing, but the guitar playing and the singing and the drumming and the bass playing and the crowd is. So we're going to finish tonight, well, not quite finished, but we're going to give you an absolute classic. I bet you can guess what it is. This is Led Zeppelin with Stairway to Heaven from the Greens Playhouse in 1973. It's 10 minutes long. If you don't like Led Zeppelin, go get a cup of tea and we'll have a chat afterwards.
Thank you. Thank you.
Wow.
That was pretty good. He's singing so well there.
I know. And the drumming in the middle of it was insane. You know, absolutely insane.
And nobody was clapping.
No.
In the song. Out of time. He was just listening. They're probably all on their phones. Oh, wait.
Filming it, yeah. But, I mean, that...
No one's in their phone.
Don't make any apologies for playing. I mean, I know it's one of these songs, isn't it? That gets over. It's like, Skinner, Freebird or Paranoid or, Ziggy or whatever. You know, the songs that get overplayed and overplayed and overplayed. And a lot of the time, I think, and I know I do, I get sick of them. It's like Silver Machine. You know, listen to that and I go, it's a good song, but I've heard it a million times, And that's a song I've probably heard 2 million times. But every now and again, it just still connects. And I can understand why it was, I think in Tommy Vance's show, it was either first or second for 20 years, wasn't it? And Supper's Ready. But brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. So, whew. So thanks ever so much for tuning in, folks. Just a couple of things to finish. Remember, we're coming up to our get-together in Glasgow. Can't wait for that. Really looking forward to it. There are still a few tickets left. If you fancy coming along and joining us, I'll put it on the screen for you. I'm all zapped up here. I'm forgetting what I'm doing. It'd be great to see some of you there. Can't wait to see everybody, actually. It's going to be a right laugh. I'm going to put I'm drinking that. I've thrown the can away. I'm an alcohol-free beer tonight again. My bladder and my kidneys and my liver are all in training for that night. It's going to be a bit mental. Thanks very much for those of you who have sent us money for tickets this week. It's been really great. It's really, really much appreciated. So thank you. Anything else you want to say, mate?
No, mate. I'm just going to have a cup of tea and I'll lie down now.
Right. So. But there's always one thing we do at the end, isn't there? We're going to have an after-show Zoom again tonight. We have it every week and it's great. And if you'd like to join us, it's just a laugh. Now, there's been some frustrations for me on this because people have been trying to join us and found it difficult for some reason. I honestly don't know why, because there's a group of about 12 to 15 people who are getting in every week, no bother. But there are some people, I just don't know what it is. So if you do try this week and it doesn't work for you, would you mind DMing me, direct messaging me or emailing us? Because I need to get to the bottom of it. I don't like the fact folk are trying to join us, Andy, and we can't get them to join the after-show drinks. So please have a go at that. And my name is Scott MacArthur. You've been watching Glasgow Apollo Live. It's only, what's the date today? Oh, it's only 2 weeks till we get together, folks. Not long at all. So thanks for tuning in. My name's Scott MacArthur. I'm sat here in the roof of my wee house in the Cotswolds. And he is?
My name is Andy Muir, and I am sitting in a cloudy Sydney.
I'm not sure he knows where he is.
Never know where you are.
It's always the best way. Good to see everybody. See you next week. All the best. Good night. Now all I need to do is hit the right button, Andy. Oh, there it is. Bye.